just when you thought it was safe to go back in the water, the swim with the promises. I don't know. Anyway, I do want to add something to this list. Here, you're watching this, so there's another video here. So I want to talk just really quickly and show you one thing about try and catch. So if you remember where I left off with promise.all, what I had is I have this particular, and I kind of made some modifications in between the last video and this one, but I have this particular JavaScript program using the p5.js library that makes a bunch of calls to WordNik and the Giphy API, and when everything is done and it's finished with all those calls, they're all promises, I get back some results and I place them all in the DOM with a paragraph element and image elements. Now, the problem here, and again, promise.all is not necessarily the best solution for this anyway, but since I'm demonstrating it, the main issue here is if any of those, it's all or nothing. If any single one of those has an error, like there isn't a GIF associated with that word available in the Giphy API, the whole thing doesn't do it. It doesn't do anything. So just about every time I run this, I'm not getting anything. Now let me just make it work by let me just get like three of them and let me just say they're all gonna be three letter words. I think this will probably work, right. So I got three GIFs with three letter words. So you can see that worked. But what I want is, I want it to work anyway, and I want to see a two-letter word, a three-letter word, four, five, six, seven, and so let's do that. Ah, whoa, it actually worked. So that was the first time that worked. But most of the time, we're going to get an error. So there's a way around this, and it is, not a way around this, but there's another concept that could help here that's important, which is try and catch. So a place that I could use, what I want to do is individually handle error messages differently. And a way that I can do that here is I can handle the error message myself and not cause it to fail by using a try catch here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to say let image URL equal null. So I'm going to assume that I'm starting with the idea that there isn't an image URL. Then I'm going to try to get the image URL try to get the image URL. I'm getting sleepy after making all these videos. I'm going to try to get the image URL from the data. Now, it might not exist. That's fine. I'm just going to try. Then I'm going to return JSON1.word and image URL. Now, this will be null if this doesn't work. So I can now go up. Oops. I can go back up in my code, and I can say, hey, if results index i.image equals null, you know, as long as it's not null, do this. So this now should let everything keep going and it will only just skip making an image where there wasn't one. Let's see if that works. Okay. Ah, all right, so fine. I was thinking I could demonstrate this without a catch and then show you the catch next. I thought there might be like a default catch, but clearly there's not. That makes sense, right? So, and there's a finally thing too. I'll have to come back to that another time. But what it's saying is like, hey, if you're going to try something, I can try it, but you got to tell me what to do if things go wrong. Like, you're in charge now. Like, the error isn't just going to be handled however it's going to be handled. So I need to actually say catch, and the catch actually gets inside of here, it's like a function. It's not an argument, and I could call that error. So I'm actually going to catch that error. I'm going to say console.log, no image found for JSON1.word. And then I'm also going to just say console.error. I might as well print out that error as well. And let's just call it ERR just so we have things named differently. So I think this is right now. Now what I'm doing is I'm saying, hey, let me try to grab the image URL. If it doesn't exist, just spit something out to the console, but keep going. So let's see if this works now. Whoa. Right, it didn't find it for any of them. Weird. Okay, so I got a mistake somewhere because it only didn't find it for one of them. I think I've got something wrong somewhere. Oh. Oh, what would I do here? If this is like total nonsense. This is what I need to eat lunch, people. I should not be making this video tutorial right now. That was total nonsense what I wrote before. What I'm saying is, as long as the results image is not null, not image equal to null. That makes no sense at all. Let's try that again. Great. Now they all, unfortunately, they all worked. But you can see now it worked, but no image found for Fuller. And we should see that Fuller is still here, but just no image is associated with it. So no image found for Fuller, no image found for whatever that word is. And so now this goes through, but I can sort of see what are the things where it doesn't work. Okay, so I have talked to you about, now I added this last little bit about try and catch. All right, weird edit point. I'm getting some interesting feedback on the chat that's things like people use try, catch too much, and that try, catch is useful, but it should be used as a last resort if all your other stuff fails. So again, I'm not necessarily suggesting that the way that I've done this is the optimal way to create this word GIF generator. I mean, ultimately, if I wanted to do that, I'd probably want to not just like have 100 promises that all happen all at once. I'd want to animate and sequence and make things interactive, and maybe I type in a word, all sorts of possibilities. But I'm trying to show you the bits and pieces and features. So the important thing here, I think, is that you can write an asynchronous function that returns a promise without ever saying promise by using the await keyword and the async keyword. You can use promise.all to execute some code when a whole lot of promises are finished, and the results will always come in the same order as the array. And but you can also sequence processing promises with .then. Okay? So there's some other things that I should do, like I should use enhanced object literals, which is like an ES6 feature. Maybe I'll come back and talk about that in a video. That thing with the strings, what's the thing with the strings? Strings, ES6, literals, there's like a thing, template literals. I should use that. So somebody remind me in another video, I'll talk about some other ES6 features like template literals and enhanced object literals. Now just go look up those things on your own, little tidbits here. Goodbye.